Now, here's an iPhone tip that I bet you did not know about. Now, let's say you have several apps on one of your iPhone's home screens and you want a way to quickly organize or clean up those apps. Let's start by placing your phone into jiggly mode by holding down your finger on the screen until all the apps start to jiggle. Now, with your one hand, you're gonna select the very first app that you wanna go ahead and move, and with the other hand, you're gonna choose the apps that you want to organize simply by tapping on each of the individual apps. Now, this creates a stack of apps underneath your finger with the number of apps that you're moving or relocating indicated on the very top of the app. Now, once you've selected all the apps, you can drag them to a different screen, a new folder, even the app library, it doesn't really matter. And when you're ready, simply lift up your finger to place the apps in the desired location, and there you have it. You quickly organize your home screen, going from messy to marvelous in just about a minute. And if you like that tip, today's video has 9 more tips and tricks so you can get the most out of your iPhone. Are you ready? Let's get started. What is going on, everyone? My name is Mike Caputo and welcome back to my channel where I help people just like you get the most out of their tech. I'm glad you're with me today because we are covering the second part of my iPhone Ultimate Guide where I show you how to get the most out of your iPhone. Now, if you haven't seen the first video where I cover 12 settings that you must change, I'm gonna link it in the cards above as well as the video description below so you can check it out whenever you want because there are some gems in there, trust me about that one. And if you're new here and you wanna get the most from your iPhone, your iPad, your Mac, make sure you hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you can get notified when more content like this is available. Now, I can't tell you how many times this next tip here has come in handy for me. I use it all the time. It's really saved me a ton of frustration. That's the ability to automatically share your Wi-Fi password without really needing to remember any of the complex letters or numbers you have set up for that password. It really is gonna help you when you have friends or family over this holiday season. People are gonna come to your house, you're gonna go to their house. This is gonna get you set up on their Wi-Fi network with ease. First, open up the settings app and click on Wi-Fi. Now there's a top section there that's labeled Wi-Fi and it shows the network name that you are connected to. You're gonna go ahead and click on the inspector button and that's gonna open up a new page. Now the second section shows the password field, but it's obfuscated with some asterisks. Hold down your finger in the password field and then your iPhone is gonna authenticate you to show you that password. But if you wanna take that one step further, you can share the password through AirDrop as long as the person has an iPhone running the most recent version of software and they're in range of Bluetooth and Wi-Fi. Now to do this, you'll see a pop-up on the phone asking if you wanna share the Wi-Fi password. Choose yes, and the password is automatically filled on their iPhone. Now if you thought number 2 was incredible, this next tip is gonna blow your mind because it demonstrates how much Apple's continually improving the features on the apps that we use on a daily basis right under our noses. Now new in iOS 17 this year is sound recognition. And this is kind of a whole suite of services that are just more broadly than just iOS 17. But this has actually been rolled into the Photos app and you can now search your library for people laughing, giving a speech, when people are clapping. There's a whole bunch of audio contexts that are available for search. Now I've gotten this to work with laughter, talk, applause, speech as the audio types. Let's go ahead and open up Photos on our iPhone. We're gonna click on the magnifying glass in the far right-hand side. Now, once we're there, we're gonna go ahead and tap into the search bar. Now, I wanna search for any photo of a baby containing laughter. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna type in baby. Let's go ahead and type in laughing, and you can see here that the number of search results actually has been pared down from 1900 down to 43. And laughing's got like a little waveform next to it, which is actually kind of cool because you can now search for specific moments that may have been more memorable, either people laughing, people telling a speech, if you were, you know, at a concert, all of that. And it's actually kind of a cool feature. Now I want to know what gems that you find in your photo album. Let me know what the best example is or what your favorite example is down in the comments below. Now let's talk about number 4. We want to keep prying eyes and prying fingers away from our iPhone. Now we'll do that by restricting access to our iPhone's control center when the device is locked. Now you're probably asking yourself, hey, why would I even wanna do that? Well, I've got a great answer for you. What you'd wanna do is you'd wanna limit any bad actor who might gain access to your phone from a physical perspective, from turning off cellular services, turning off Wi-Fi, turning off Bluetooth, having access to your wallet, all those things that you'd wanna go ahead and do in case someone were to get possession of your phone. Now to do this, let's go to settings. Let's go to Face ID and Passcode and scroll down to the bottom where it says Allow Access When Locked section. From there, you can toggle the features that you want to lock down. Now, I would suggest turning off access to Control Center, turning off access to Wallet, turning off access to return phone calls. Again, you want to be able to limit or control how much access someone would have in case the event happens where someone has physical access to your device. Now, we've all been there before. We are expecting an important phone call, and for whatever reason, that call doesn't get delivered to our phone. Maybe we are in silent mode, maybe we are in some kind of focus mode, but that call doesn't get delivered And that really has put a damper on our day. We're in a situation, well, this next feature, which is called emergency bypass, it's like giving someone the red phone. You know, like in the presidential office, there's that phone that's red, it allows anyone to pick it up and they get right to the president. This is what that feature is like, because no matter what state your phone is in, it is gonna ring with this feature turned on. Now, to set up emergency bypass, first let's open up contacts and let's select the contact that you never wanna miss a call or text from. Hit edit, scroll down to where it says ringtone, and here you'll find an option for emergency bypass. Now, what that means is that this individual, whoever you selected, will always be elevated a level above your focus mode, your do not disturb mode, allowing this specific contact to always be able to call you or text you. You would need to set them up individually. And it's really just like having a VIP list for your iPhone. Now, next up, I'm gonna show you how to delete search results in Spotlight. Now, maybe you search for something that you shouldn't have, you type something wrong, who knows, but you just don't want this poor quality search result showing up every time you go to search for something in Spotlight. Well, if you have Spotlight pulled up, what you can go ahead and do on any of these search results, really, it's very simple. If you just slide to the right, you'll see the clear button. Boom, it's gone. Wasn't that simple? Now let's talk about number 7. We're gonna switch gears into something that we use every day, but we probably don't maximize it to its fullest extent, and that is gonna be iMessage. Yes, it is more than just sending text, emojis, and memes to your friends. We're gonna clean house today. Now, Apple's redesigned the app drawer in iOS 17, but it is stocked with junk, and I don't wanna see all that, and I can't imagine that you do either. Let's go and open up settings. We're gonna go to iMessage, and once we have iMessage open, we're gonna go to the third panel, which says Message Apps. And here we're gonna turn off any unnecessary apps that we don't wanna see when we click on the plus button. This will directly reduce the number of apps that appear in the iMessage app drawer. Like, you really need to have iMessage app from Home Depot? I mean, why? Why Home Depot? But here I've got two additional bonus tips for you. Instead of clicking on the plus button here, then clicking on camera or photos, what you can go ahead and do, if you wanna just add photos, just hold on the plus button for a second and you're gonna get right into the photo picker, which is awesome because it instantly appears, cuts down on the number of key presses that you have. Second, once you have the app drawer open, well, maybe you don't want an emoji all the way at the top. I'm gonna click on this. You can reorganize this any way you want, dropping them in, again, the order that you want, making it more relevant to how you use your iPhone, and that is what we are all about here. Now, we're gonna keep it on the same topic of messages. If you're anything like me and you use multiple Apple devices, like you have an iPhone, you have an iPad, maybe you have a Mac, it's really nice to have your text messages forwarded to your other devices when you receive them on your iPhone, but you wanna make sure that you're not still forwarding messages to older devices that you no longer have. So let's go back into settings, go to messages, and we're gonna go to text message forwarding. You wanna make sure that any device that you have here is turned off that you're no longer using, because you wanna make sure, again, you're not being bombarded with system notifications that you don't want in other places, as well as not forwarding those messages to devices that you're no longer using. And there you have two simple yet effective messaging tweaks, allows you to get the most out of messages on your device. So go ahead and text away. Just be smarter about it. Now let's go to number 9, copy and paste photo edits. Photos got a lot of love this year, and now you have the ability to take a photo edit that you apply towards one phone and have it copy and pasted towards a number of different photos, like in a batch edit, which is really a huge time saver. So what we wanna go ahead and do here is we wanna go ahead and find a photo in our photo library. I'm still looking at baby photos. I'm gonna go ahead and click on this photo here. I'm gonna edit it. Now I'm gonna make the photo a little bit warmer. I'm gonna make it a little bit less sharp, and I'm gonna turn on auto. Now once that's done, I'm gonna click on this top ellipsis here in the top right-hand corner. I'm gonna click on copy edits. And now that I've copied the edits, they're basically on my clipboard. I can click on a number of different photos. I'm going to click on that same context menu, but which is now here at the bottom. And I should have an option there to paste edits, and I'm done. Very easy. So if you want to have a uniform style across a number of different photos, it's very easy to edit one photo and then have those edits apply to a number of different photos just by copying and paste them, just like on the Mac. Now, number 10 is where things get very cool. If you have an iPhone 11 or newer, you can set up a double tap or a triple tap, which is an accessibility feature, to function on the back of your phone to either run a shortcut or run a specific action, which is really cool because it gives you additional hardware capabilities on a phone, you know, kind of expanding the access, just like how the action button does on the iPhone 15. Now to set this up, we're gonna go ahead and open up settings. We're gonna click on accessibility. Then in the first section titled physical and motor, we're gonna click on touch. And on the bottom, you see back tap. We're gonna click on that one. And then you see double tap and triple tap. And as I talked about in my previous video, this is the exact reason why I removed the flashlight shortcut from Control Center, because now I can actually just tap on my phone 3 times. It's gonna turn on the flashlight. I don't need to worry about pulling down the Control Center and then looking for it. It actually works a lot better for me. But really what I would suggest to you is, you know, go in here, explore these accessibility settings, You know, they're designed for people who have special needs, but they are applicable to, you know, for other reasons. So I would suggest exploring and seeing what you can find on your phone that might make it a little bit more powerful for you. You will not regret it. Now, we have covered a ton of different features today. Everything from optimizing your iPhone, the home screen, making sure that your phone always rings, supercharging your experience, just a ton of stuff. If I taught you something new that you didn't know, give it a thumbs up. Maybe you want to share it with someone who might find it useful. And if you want to stay up to date with the latest tips and tricks and hidden features, hit that subscribe button. Now, if you got a hidden feature that maybe I didn't talk about or something that you really love, let me know what it is down in the comments below. And if you've made it this far, put a shamrock emoji so I know who made it to the end of the video. My name is Mike, and I will talk to you in the next one.